That's like Bugs Bunny if he's inside a bell and they hit the bell.
A, you fucking you hit the button too hard. Let's try this again.
I get that a lot.
B, that was way more of a fucked up didgeridoo. Are there any didgeridoo players in the group? I want to collaborate with a didgeridoo player out there.
Words!
I edited that out.
Fuck.
Yeah, so no one knows what
you're... That was gold!
You can make a fucking Pis N Cox theme.
Is that a didgeridoo? Are you a didgeridooer? If you're bad, they go, how about you didgeridoo-don't? What?
Boo!
No!
Boo!
That's like a fucking... That's a dad joke. Yeah, smelly musk.
What are we drinking?
We are drinking beer from Gregg Collins and Joseph Harris this week.
Well, one can. This is the last can that we have of you, Joseph Harris. Now, what are you starting with?
I'm going with the Atwater Brewery Dirty Blonde. Wheat ale brewed with orange peel and coriander. You had me at coriander.
Now, I'm starting with the Joseph Harris. I mean, something about a can this morning just seemed really enticing. Yeah.
Work your way.
Like, I'm trying to think of something else. I'm trying to.
Let's get rid of the non-murdered beetle.
He was almost murdered.
I didn't know that until just recently.
Yeah.
Yes. Let's talk about our baby.
It is the size of a coconut.
Yes.
There's no lime in it.
No. Oh, great reference.
Thank you.
So good. Ken Jacobus will get that.
Well, I think pretty much everyone.
Not everybody.
Are you saying I'm putting too much credit on people?
Some people. A husked. Yeah.
What do you mean a husk?
Have you seen a coconut?
We didn't talk about if we are going to husk or not husk our baby.
Have you seen a coconut, the coconut
I
husk?
Just gave you a gold circumcision reference, and you...
I was so busy getting back to, I was getting back to the husk thing.
I got my first bloody nipple last week, and I didn't know it was bleeding until I was getting into the shower, and I told my... Kara, look it! I'm a runner!
There it is.
This areola... has seen some shit.
Okay.
Someday, you'll spread those wings.
Someday.
You'll grow into a beautiful swan. Right now, you're just an ugly duckling.
Thanks, buddy.
You're welcome.
Oh, it's not a drum roll. It's already public knowledge.
Drum roll, please.
You'll
I'm
never guess.
You already
you'll
know.
You'll never guess what happened.
Clinton motherfucking Jackson.
Oh, my God.
Is what happened. I'm so excited, and I just can't hide it.
Up to that news, and I was infinitely happier than it was previous to getting that news. Let's not put that in as
I learned of these events that unfolded, and
as I...
before I read them, I was happy. Upon reading them, I was exponentially happier. I just want to hear, like, at all points of the course, either Sean Corbell.
Yep.
Telling me my best will make me better.
Absolutely.
Bagpipes in the distance.
Be nice.
And Clinton Jackson yelling at me.
Yep. When you read the news, at any time did you think to yourself, oh shit, that means they're going to make an electroshock obstacle more prominent now since he's going to be there?
Yeah, but it also made me think that they're getting smart and realizing they can utilize him in so many more roles.
Talented guy.
Like, it's not the electroshock that makes Clinton... It's Clinton that makes the electroshock.
That's deep.
I know. A game changer.
All caps, as if you were yelling,
game changer! By Brady Archer.
Yeah, yeah.
$100,000 giveaway.
Thanks, Stellacor. The $100,000 World's Toughest Mudder Team Challenge. I believe it's first team. I haven't seen specifically laid out, but it's got to be just the first team. Because if five teams make it,
shit,
we didn't think that many teams were going to make it.
I want you to welcome this man who's going to attempt the impossible, the $10,000 free throw from the other side of the court, the moonshot.
Right on.
All right. This is human drama at its best. Just focusing, taking a moment to concentrate. That's okay.
Yes! Holy shit! I'm a miracle! Woo!
Father Patty stepped on the line. He stepped on the line.
No, it was legal.
No, he stepped on the line. You were looking at it. Come on.
Jackie, he made the shot.
Who the hell has $10,000?
Relax, the beer company will pay him.
We're not really a sponsor, just sounded professional.
Congratulations to Dukes! He just won a giant check that says $10,000!
Cool!
Look at the size of that thing!
But that's really just a stepping stone to the even bigger announcement.
$200,000!
Whoa! Great job, headquarters and Brady, for announcing $100,000. Yeah. But did you even think $200,000?
I don't know why they didn't.
Yeah.
Obviously, people in the community did.
First team to get to 200 miles.
Great job, guys.
Yeah, put together by...
So Matty, you got...
Ken Jacobus, Ken. Keith Allen, the GOAT, the GOAT. Jim Campbell... OCR bus, Quesadilla yep. Elite, Burrito Elito.
Great name.
May the odds be ever in your favor.
It's Vegas after all.
Is this the Mockingjay?
Did you just catcall me? What was that?
That's the...
Settle down, sailor!
Have you even seen the Hunger Games?
I've seen the first one.
I like how I whistle, and you're like, stop it.
You're so vain. Song is about you. You're so vain.
You're so vain.
I bet you think this song is about you. Don't you? Don't you? Oh, yeah.
I'm actively taking applications.
He likes to call dicks applications.
It's going to be in 2 weeks. You will not be here.
Correct.
And why is that?
I'm going to be in Nashville.
I've been to Nashville. It is a fantastic.
Have you been to Nashville?
Oh, it's a great town.
I've never been, and I'm super excited.
It is a fun. Fun city.
What now, the reason that we're going to be there, it's my fourth conference for Anytime Fitness that I'll be attending.
I remember your first.
Yeah, Chicago.
Oh. We are a beacon of light to everyone that is known bad. Not all of you know what you represent, and I want to stand here today to remind you what you represent. You are not the light at the end of the tunnel, because the light at the end of the tunnel means that you're dead. We are the ones who show people how to enjoy the tunnel. We are the ones that get people to realize that we're not here for a quick 3 month transformation, but we're here to take our bodies back, to take our minds back. And we represent that to people that don't know how to do it.
This conference is a little bit...
Tell me, it's more special.
I got asked to design, assemble a team, and lead up the world record attempt for largest simultaneous group workout in the heart of Nashville on the Walk of Fame.
Do you know what the current record is?
2,180. So we're looking at minimum 2,200 people. If there's anybody in the Tennessee area, August 28th.
Those states are so small over there. You guys can venture
hours. I don't know. I'm from California. Everything's far away.
Tim Holt will drive down from where he is.
Yeah.
Now we
Nashville, Tennessee.
Now he has to
Walk
watch
of Fame.
Right.
Let me get it out.
Okay.
August 28th.
August
5 p.m. is when the workout starts. I reached out to Coach Kyle and I said, hey, I got this little shindig going on.
I'm doing this thing.
And I'd like to pay some homage, if you will. I would like to loosen up the hips of this large group. And I would like to shout you out and have them do the coach hip swivel.
The most important part of any athletic activity stems right here in my hips. Let's get them warm. Other direction.
So yeah, I'm going to shout them out. I'm going to have the group do the...
You can't
the...
see if my hips are fucking doing an awesome circle or not.
All right.
No,
I've
good.
Seen better.
You have not.
I wish you had more power behind them.
Well, I'm getting there.
Jason, hey. Realize how unrealistic my fantasies about
Did
you are.
Did legs today. I'm a little sore. I'm just saying.
Second part, I'm wearing the man's shirt in honor of fellow World's Toughest Mudder alum, Paul Anthony Trujillo. This is his club. He's also employed by Anytime Fitness.
Santa Clara, California. What?
Say what? He's part of the Workout Avengers team that's been assembled to take this on.
So he's going out there too?
Yeah, oh, he's not only going out there, he is part of the, yeah. Bum, bum, he's part bum, of... Ba-dum,
bum, ba-dum. Luke, I let you kiss your sister.
I'll be gone. I'll be doing that.
Oh, shit. Beer number two. This is the...
Tell me what that is.
This is Oddside Ale's Bean Flicker Blonde Ale with coffee. Satisfying stimulation... of sessionable self-exploration. This is the best named beer I've ever heard in my entire life. Don't actually, that's a little aggressive.
I don't know moderation. Is this sexy?
Does that turn you on?
Is this, am
is
I
that,
doing it?
Does that turn you on?
Did I turn off the stove? Mine is Hop Slam Ale Brewed with Honey.
Slam! Let the boys be boys! I love that song.
Hannah Copper, have you heard of her?
I know who she is.
Yeah.
She's very sweet.
Yeah, she's
what
all right.
I understand. Yeah.
Excellent blog. Did you read it?
I did. She has been battling a bit with injuries.
The injury,
and,
yeah.
Oh, and just horrific. Like one, it's like, oh, I got pneumonia. I've got strep throat. I've got laryngitis. I've got...
Oh, I gained 163 pounds.
John Corbell actually shared it with on his page with some people who were like looking for some...
And that reminds me because I should share it as well.
Oh, my...
Matt. Your fourth favorite?
No, actually, I'll be honest. Matthew Lowe is actually quickly become... He's like ratcheting up the ranks. Matthew Lowe was so disgusted at the way that we drank...
Oh, and let's be real. It wasn't just Matthew Lowe. It was pretty much anybody who has any knowledge on how to properly drink.
Whiskey?
Yeah, but here's the deal. This was the best outcome that you could have gotten.
Yeah.
You gave whiskey to a couple of monkeys.
You didn't want us to drink it right, let's be honest.
Yeah, like, we don't know. Like, so...
Had to occur. Thanks again, though, by the way.
Absolutely. And it was a blast drinking it.
Yeah.
We look forward to learning how to drink it properly.
Yeah, now that we've got these brand new whiskey glasses, thank you, Matthew Lowe, we're going to revisit that and drink it out of the proper glasses. He baked Cassie Harris a cake.
Well, yeah, and they also went out drinking together and hung out. And
things he's done with her, but not us.
You know what his argument to that would be? He was in California. Where were we?
He was in the wrong part. California's a gigantic state.
Yeah,
he was in the wrong
part. You were in any other part of the country, you were literally like four states away.
Come
but
engineer,
because it's California, it's like, oh, same state.
Come engineer up here. Yeah, we'll hug you.
It's true. Mm-hmm. What was awesome is that I get to the gym and Melanie, she's a rebel. She goes, hey... I almost did it, but I didn't. I want to send you some proper whiskey snifters. And I'm like, and I started laughing immediately. I'm like, you know, it's already been done.
Sometimes
we irritated
takes
a lot
care of its own.
People. Yeah. You know, you put a couple of bumbling idiots in front of a camera long enough, people eventually start to go, oh, come here.
I'm bummed that no one even like mentioned how great we were with the terminology, though. We got that shit right.
Glengiddy.
Right?
Yeah, said that correctly. Okay. I hate that the professional guy fucked us over and he's all swilling it and Rick Hutchinson's like, don't you dare!
You know what I love the most? We're talking about Matthew Lowe. Nothing about what's actually on our agenda to talk about Matthew Lowe about.
Oh yeah, he's a fruit shooter.
He's a fruit shooter. As if we didn't know that. You know what I'm saying?
I just wanted to say that so I could give the two dicks thing.
Is that what that is? What TMHQ just calls up Jason Rulo like, yo, bitch, let's talk about your feelings about things.
Like $100,000 challenge, look at Jason Rulo and not get a boner.
That's a good point. I owe someone $100,000. Oh, there it is. That's a boy. Are you like holding one as you put it in my face? Is that what you're doing?
Yeah, that's how big it is.
Oh, wow, that's impressive.
Yeah.
Good for you.
Did you read the interview?
Yes, I did. It was really good, I thought.
My takeaway from it was that is exactly what I do these Tough Mudder events for and why I'm hooked on World's Toughest is that it's for the people. It's for the experience.
Dude.
They're priceless. Like, it's all in perspective.
Yes.
And I've met some of the coolest, craziest people doing this.
Seriously.
And have had some of the most insane experiences doing this. And that's what it's all about.
It, you know what? And I was reminded of that this past weekend. I did a half marathon. It's the biggest difference why I love OCR stuff so much more than like regular distance racing. Is I am bored out of my mind. That half marathon, as fun as it was, nobody's talking, everyone's got their headphones in, and it's like there's absolutely, I'm just by myself for an hour and 45 minutes, like, and I'm like, people are like, come up on me, and I'm like, no. It's just, I miss the camaraderie aspect, I think, of OCR can't be underestimated, because it's like, it makes such a huge difference.
All I'm saying is you clearly haven't run a half marathon with Electric Light Orchestra, REO Speedwagon, Night Rangers, Celine Dion, and Dolly Parton's Greatest Hits.
No, I ran it with Metallica and NoFX and The Offspring and Authority Zero. John Mayer, by the way. just to change it up a little
what?
Bit.
What? Yeah. Slayer, yeah. Anthrax, oh. Megadeth.
Yes.
John Legend.
John Legend.
What?
Robert Hunka Hunka Burn Love.
We've just been putting an emphasis on the wrong syllable.
Former yeah. goalie of the New Jersey Devils, Martin Brodeur. We've been calling him Brodeur, but it's actually...
Brodeur.
Brodeur. According to the Robert Top Meta video that we're referencing.
Get off the couch. There's a lot more out there. It's something like this. I mean, once you do one, you're going to be addicted. Rob Brodeur, I'm from Sturbridge, Massachusetts, coming up on my 39th birthday. Number 40 was around the corner, and having gone through two ACL knee surgeries and two microfractures, and the doctor telling me, you know, you're gonna give it up, play golf. You know, as much as my daughter doesn't like to see me get shocked and go through the fire, she was like, wow, you know, she goes, Dad, you did really well. You know, and she's like, I'm proud of you. And, you know, when they tell you something like that, you know, you know, you hear stories about people say, you know, they told me I'd never walk or I'd never do this again. And I said, you know, I'm going to be that guy. I'm going to get out there. And I just finished about 10 minutes ago and I'm ready for the next one.
Super dad.
Super dad.
Didn't know that about his knee. Him and I were messaging back and forth a little bit. And he's like, we're just talking about how excited we were about World's Toughest coming up. And he's like, yeah, I just hope my knee holds up. And I'm like, feel like I'm out of the loop. What's up
with
I missed.
Buddy?
He goes, mind if I send you a video? It explains it all.
He's had two ACL reconstructions.
What have you had?
Two ACL reconstructions. He's in his 40s. I'm in my 40s. He doesn't like clowns. I don't like clowns. He's disgustingly handsome. I'm moderately attractive on a good day.
We make some butt babies. I'm surprised that we've gone 31 episodes.
And you never used
That's my first reference to butt babies.
Butt babies.
I'm disappointed. Grace. I'm sorry, Mom. Trevor Holland.
Yeah, that poor guy.
Out.
Looking high, looking low.
You missed my Hall & Oates reference.
No, I got it.
Oh, okay.
I just didn't think it was that funny.
He's a man eater.
No. Oh.
Oh, here I come.
We haven't referenced him.
All over your face and in your eyes. He's looking.
He's looking for a fourth team member. Poor guy's never been referenced in our show ever. He's like, hey, everybody, I was mentioned in this web show. It's fucking come in your nostrils, come in your ears, come. Oh, never mind. Wow. He's got a threesome. He's looking for a fourth.
Yeah. So if you're looking to hop in on a World's Toughest Mudder gangbang, they're all showing up and they're getting ready to fuck that course.
With their gat and their.
We're talking two different gangbangs. We're looking for some team. Trevor Holland.
Trevor Holland wants a fourth member on his team, please. He's trying to get that 100K.
Who's not?
I'm not, actually.
Yeah,
no, we're not.
Are, no.
No. We'd be like team 10K.
Should be team cried only 8 times. Speaking of teams, though.
Yeah. Which team?
Clyde's fucking Dale.
Yeah.
Do your thing. Okay, now stick your tongue out.
Nope.
What? Hey, look up. We need two of our babies. Some Monty Python this shit.
What are the qualifications for a Team Clydesdale member?
Team Clydesdale, you gotta be 200 plus pounds.
You gotta be upwards of 200 plus.
Yeah, and that's essentially it.
That's it.
Let's make it a thing. Let's make it fucking official. I didn't know so many people were like, fuck yeah. So, yeah, we gotta roll together with a pack of Clydesdales. Truck that Budweiser everywhere. I think Shock Top's owned by Budweiser.
They are, actually. Yeah, they're a subsidiary of. Correct. Aww.
Time for...
Community questions. Time for... Community questions time for 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 community questions.
Keith Allen says, will you two knuckleheads produce a show with the length a working adult with two insane children will have time to watch?
Yeah, we did it already.
Yeah, did you not see it already?
Yeah, next question.
Chris Maxfield, he says, what would it take to get the two of you to run your last lap in a costume? But wait, he adds a caveat, of course. Something epic to be voted on by the community. Remember, I said last lap.
Yeah, I don't think I could commit to that.
I can't either. There's no way.
He did ask, what would it take? It would take like 25 grand.
Actually, that's right. You're right. Like, 25 grand, I would do it.
That would definitely make me go, grand, hold on.
I would let the community choose.
Oh, absolutely.
What outfit I am to wear on my last
25 lap. G's, y'all. Let's do it.
A piece.
No, I'd split it. So I guess that's me saying 1250.
Kelly Allen, the brains of the operation, as we call her, she says, what are you going to do? This is a great thought. I hadn't thought about this. What are you going to do when your baby is 40 weeks and there's still a month until Will's Toughest Mudder? Is there going to be a birth episode or will it be just one super overdue baby?
Jackie Chan, he is rumored, said to be born after being 12 months in the womb.
Do you think it's right?
I don't know, because I also read stuff that says that's impossible, that could never happen. I don't know. I think that impossibilities are just things that haven't been done yet, and maybe Jackie Chan's done it already.
A certain someone says, can I get a shout-out? I think he should.
Absolutely.
And tell him why Chris Aranda is getting a shout-out this week.
He answered the call to arms.
He did.
This isn't going to be doing the Whataburger anymore.
Not until
World's Toughest. He's going to do fantastic.
He messaged me privately and was like, I accept the challenge. And I was like,
yeah, Urgh. Me too. And honestly, that was my favorite part of last week's episode and one that I wasn't really anticipating.
It was totally organic.
So many people messaged me, and I'm assuming you as well, saying, hey, that really put it in my head. Like, we're this close. You know, there's probably things that I could do to better myself.
90-something days. 93, whatever it is now.
So, Chris Aranda, fuck yeah, you can get a shout-out. Vanessa, too.
Good old Brian Muttee says, community questions on a Tuesday, which, by the way, I totally thought it was Wednesday when I posted it. My bad. Thanks for calling me out, Charles Hopper.
What an idiot.
He says, might we actually see the 31st week segment of Pis N Cox on Friday?
No. So the new system that we've kind of come into that really works well for me is we'll film on a Thursday.
Mm-hmm.
And then that gives me, like, I can edit it over time. I'll edit a little bit today.
Take your time.
I'll edit a little bit tomorrow.
Take your time.
I'll edit a little bit on Sunday, and I'll finish it on Monday. That way, I don't have to sit in front of a computer for, like, 8 hours at a time.
No, I can just do
a couple hours here, a couple hours there.
Especially when you're not getting paid, let's be honest.
Right.
You're not getting paid.
But it is fun, and I love it.
Domenick Deutsch says, what's the best way to let a kid down easy?
I don't believe in letting a kid down easy. They're going to grow up sooner or later. You might as well supply that,
life lesson. Was it Iron Man 3 with a little kid? And he's like trying to talk to Tony Stark about how his parents died, whatever. He's like, yeah, life stuff, get over it. Mike Wacker, what will be the highest mileage total achieved by a Clydesdale? And for a, as we learned in the group, there's something else called a super mega fucking Clydesdale.
Right.
Yeah. What's the difference?
Over 250? Yeah.
Right.
So 2 to 250 or 249 if you want to get technical is going to be Clydesdale. Super mega fucking Clydesdale is 250 plus.
Got it.
Regular Clydesdale, I'm going to say 65 miles. Super mega fucking Clydesdale, I'm going to say 50 miles.
Okay. All right. I'm with you.
55 miles.
There you go.
Yeah.
Redacted. I like it. Robert Brodeur, Robert.
Hunka hunka.
Burn in love.
No antibiotics for that shit.
Brodeur. Wants to know, what's a not so obvious thing you recommend for your pit crew to have and or do?
Kara's done a lot of legitimate crewing for, like, real time big badass events.
Right.
She's crewed Badwater. She, as a crew member, she ran 65 miles alone through Death Valley, like, as a crew member. She would document what and how much and what the time was of everything ingested.
Oh,
liquid,
smart. That's smart.
Food. And so every lap, she had a list of first lap, ate this. Drank this.
Oh, nice.
And
the engineer in me is excited about this, by the way.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
And she also would mark down how many times we've peed.
Oh.
Huge.
But now you're wearing like a wetsuit. Would she just ask you, did you pee? And you say yes or no?
Are you peeing?
Okay.
Are you peeing?
Okay, good.
Is what she would ask. And yes, I peed once. I peed twice.
Right.
And what she's looking for is if once you start saying no, holy shit. You need to start drinking.
Right.
Walk this next lap. Don't run it. Don't overly exert yourself. Drink while you're doing it. Dominic.
You know what? He's really
Wolverine.
Nice. Should I shave my facial hair If so, when? If not, why? We totally disagree.
Get your wrong opinion out of the way so we can end on a good note with this.
I say shave it. Shave it, shave it, shave it, shave it, shave it. And you say not to shave it because?
I think you should manscape.
He does keep it pretty like,
yeah. Well, I want him to look like Wolverine. Yeah. So to shave it all off, no.
My favorite community question of every single week is brought to us by my man,
Mike Barefoot Cook.
Try again. My favorite person,
Matthew Lowe.
You're such a dick.
Keep it going.
My man, Aaron Krebs.
Cassie Harris.
That's a good point, actually. Aaron Krebs says, Rage Against the Machine's 1999 album, Battle of Los Angeles, features such epic songs as Guerrilla Radio, Sleep Now in the Fire, and Testify, but it's the artwork on the cover of the album that has him havering in the fields to the mountains and to the oceans. That fucking guy watches the show and writes shit down. I love this guy. I can't wait to meet him.
Well, we're invested now.
Yes.
We're together on
Any
this.
Chance that either of you know the artist, the L.A. street phantom, known as Joey Krebs? God damn it. Every single week. Never fails. I fucking...
It's really good beer, by the way.
Oh, my God.
I love it.
You know what? The bean flicker, A, turns me on, and B, it tastes really good.
Am I doing it? Am I sexy yet?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Matty Gregg, we can talk about that fucked up video.
Oh my God.
Now, you didn't even make it all the way through.
Well, I had to take the kids to school, but otherwise it would have.
You're like, hold on, let me finish this psychedelic mindfuck.
I got 6 minutes in, and I was like, I don't want to stop this, but I'm like, I didn't enjoy it, but I was just like...
I genuinely was uncomfortable. I'm like...
I can't stop looking at the video.
Why did that happen? Well, Donna!
Why is she
battling? Donna!
Why is she battling herself right
this
now?
This is my sermon!
Maddie doesn't want to know Cyborg versus Rousey versus Deanna Blegg in a triple threat match.
Blegg.
Yeah, no doubt.
All the way.
Yeah. Dave Blosser wants to know, if he starts the Atkins diet, can he run as fast as Ryan?
Yeah, I mean, as...
It makes sense. Hannah Copper says, finish the lyric. Sugar, sugar.
Bye, Honey Bunch. Don't you know I love you? You are my candy girl.
And you've got me
wanting
you. Quick note, Casey Harris, I love what he did with his hair.
I love me some Robert Luciano.
I love Robert Luciano because of his name.
Made Robert a shirt.
What's it say?
It stands for Fat Guys Make Bad Ninjas.
Fat Guys Make Bad Ninjas.
World's Toughest Action on the back.
That's it. Oh. Week 31 in the books.
Done.
Always so
did
good to
just shake hands.
We did just shake hands.
Well done, done sir. Well done.
Well done. Excellent episode. Week 31, the long version in the books. Cheersies!
Cheersies!